Well, welcome everybody to Lake Placid, the FISU World University Games. We're here in Mount Van Hoevenberg for the first of the biathlon contests. So this is the 15K competition, individual. They all will start at 30 second intervals. We've got 37 athletes in the field, and they will be out on the course. They do five laps of the 3K course, which takes us all the way around and through the trees and up the hill. It's quite a steep, difficult and challenging track here in Mount Van Hoevenberg. It was built for the 1980 Olympic Games, and it's a world-class, World Cup level track. It is the ultimate of combination of sports, the superb fitness needed for the cross-country skiing, and then the ability to shoot and shoot accurately with a high heart rate. So they will they'll visit the range four times. So after the first lap, they go into the range, and they're going to alternate between prone, just lying down, and standing. And if you are new to biathlon, then the prone targets are much, much smaller. We'll see as we go into the competition. The prone target's about the size of a golf ball, and the standing target about the size of a CD. There's our start list. Watch out for the Kazakhstanis in this competition today. They've got some really strong athletes. Also, watch out for the Poles as well. The Poles have got some good skiers in this competition, particularly number 34, Przemyslaw Panachets. You can see the air temperature. Well, it was 0 degrees yesterday. It's dropped to -7 Celsius, so it's a little chilly outside and high humidity. You can see the light snow. So Alexandra Mukin from Kazakhstan will get this competition underway. The 24-year-old and Mukin out on the course. So we're gonna have a good look as we follow Mukin around the first part of this course about how the track is looking and how it's panning out. This section here, just climbing up out of next to the clubhouse, next to the lodge here. We're 30 seconds start intervals. From the University of Eastern Finland, it's Matias Majala, just 22 years old. So first shoot for Mukin. Now, no penalty loops today in this competition. It's a penalty time for a missed target, and that's one missed for Mukin. Yeah, so one missed for Mukin, and so he's gonna get a penalty added onto his time. Patrick Brin into the range. Taking his time over the chute. One missed. So the same as Mukin. Number 29 there, that is Van Ledger from the Montana State University, but he's a local boy from Lake Placid. Carried the flag in the opening ceremony, just 20 years old. And a big cheer for the hometown boy. Number 16 from Kazakhstan, it's Vadim Kurales. Still the leader after the first shoot. Oh, there's a first clean from the Kazakh, and that will take the lead. And watch out for this man from Poland. Now, the Poles had some problems. Their rifles didn't arrive, and they actually had them expressly couriered by the New York State Police. They drove them all the way from the airport, I'm not sure which airport it was in New York, that they flew them into. And they arrived last night, in the middle of the night, and the police brought them here first thing in the morning. So they trained yesterday with borrowed rifles, and today they have their own rifles. So as we see Jakub Kocian come in to the range. I can tell you that Kirill Bauer is now in the lead, shot clean, and he's come out in the lead. Jakub Kocian shooting quickly and shooting good so far, and that's another clean first shoot. So you can see the athletes that are ahead, that have started earlier, they are going on to the standing shoot in the distance there. They're already on to their second time around. As we watch Alex Garnier. Good shoot from Garnier. Garnier going clean, going clear. And there is Kirill Bauer, the leader so far after the first shoot. Altering the rhythm as he comes onto the steeper section of the climb. You can see how steep this track is. So number one, so far at 14 minutes, is Patrick Brin. Is the Norwegian Museng, Michael Zaral of the Czech Republic, you can hear the wind just whistling around slightly as the Pole Panchats. He's got the experience, has 12 World Cup starts to his name. Taking his time. And misses the last one. Disappointing there for the Pole. Yeah, not good to miss the last one. Just think that you've gone clear and then just the hope of having that clean shoot snatched away at the last. 21 coming into the range for his standing shoot. Current leader. Bauer. If he can shoot this clean. A miss for Bauer. Two misses. Three misses for Kirill Bauer. Well, that has dropped him right down the potential leaderboard. So Jakub Kocian is lying in a provisional third place. And Kocian, a look of relief there as he shoots clean again. Miss there for Garnier. Well, just the one miss from Alex Garnier. So our current provisional leader is Jakub Kocian, the 22-year-old Czech. Van Ledger from the United States coming in. The flag bearer for the team at the opening ceremony, Van. This is his second time into the range. It's clean on his first. And a miss, two misses for Ledger. Disappointing. As number 16, Vadim Kurel is working hard up the hill. Immediate time, Matthias Majala leading. It's after 10.9 kilometers. As we watch the Canadian, William Moineau, being overtaken there by Jakub Kocian. Kocian doesn't perhaps have the speed of Alexander Mukin on the snow, but he's the only biathlete to have shot completely clean so far. So we see our first finisher across the line. It is Alexander Mukin in a time of 44.48.9, and he gave it all. Absolutely gave it all. Kocian. Alex Garnier looking good. Taking the lead away from Kocian at 11.6 kilometers. One more visit to the range for both Kocian and Garnier. It'll all come down between those two to how well they shoot the final standing five shots. Start of the descent, this technical turn, it's like switchbacks as you come back down the hill. Leader at 11.6 kilometers is Alex Garnier. A little bit of slipstreaming going on there. There is Alex Garnier coming into his fourth shoot. So Kocian is in the range as well. Kocian's just started, and Alex Garnier will join him. No, that one doesn't. There is Kocian, number 22. Kocian's missed. Garnier misses. And Kocan missed one. So that's the first miss that that Jakub Kocan has had all day. And 45 seconds added onto his time will drop him down the potential leaderboard. Alex Garnier missing one as well. So Garnier with two misses out onto his final loop. So leading in the finish is Alexandra Mukin, crossing the line with a time of 44.48. 44 minutes, 48. Coming in for the final and fourth shoot, the Norwegian, Ørjan Museng. Museng has missed one from each of his visits to the range. And misses one again, so four in total for the Norwegian. So Ørjan Museng of Norway starting his final lap. So currently in the finish, we have Alexandra Mukin in first with the Finn. Matthias Majala behind him, 10 seconds back in silver medal position. Crossing the line there is number 12. That is Wojciech Filip of Poland. See Jakub Kocan of the Czech Republic. And behind him, Alex Garnier of France. Garnier has missed two, Kocan has only missed one. But you can see that Garnier is skiing the quicker of the two because he's caught up. He's caught up. He's caught up. Well, so the 30-second start intervals, there's a minute there on the track. And at the finish, Vadim Kurales has just finished and just taken the lead. Kurales with only one miss, and I think Kurales could be in line for taking the gold. What can Garnier do? Nathan Livingood crossing the line. The leader, Vadim Kurales. And can either of these two change that leaderboard? Number 24 there is Garnier, 22 Jakub Kocan. French coach is going to go hoarse if he keeps shouting like that all the way through this competition. Coming around the final turn now, heading towards the finish line. Axel Garnier crosses the line. What's it going to be? Garnier goes into second place. And behind him, Jakub Kocian goes into third. So knocking Alexandra Mukin off the podium. And both of these biathletes are completely spent. Vadim Kuralis, though, still in the lead. And it's difficult to see anyone, apart from maybe the Norwegian. This Norwegian could change things up. Oiran Museng heading towards a provisional second place here. If he can put the hammer down on the final straight, yes, he's going to do it. So Museng takes silver. Garnier is going to take the bronze. And I think that is going to be the medals, with Corrales in gold, Museng in silver, and Garnier taking bronze. There are other biathletes still out on the track, but the difference is considerable. Van Ledger going into 11th place. And fifth for Stefan Kinash of Ukraine. Good result for the Ukrainian. Crossing the line there is the Pole, Panchertz. It's hard to know if it's a smile or if it's a grimace.
In the men's 15-kilometer short individual biathlon.
The confirmation that it is Kazakhstan that take the gold. Vadim Kuralis with Norway in silver, Oyan Museng and Axel Garnier in bronze.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Lake Placid.
So congratulations to the medalists. A good way to start off the biathlon competition here in Mount Van Hoevenberg.